Hey guys, how you going? My name is Dom, and in this video I'd like to take you through the URL search params object inside JavaScript. So basically this object allows you to work with query strings. So it lets you add, remove, or retrieve key value pairs from a query string. So you're actually able to construct a brand new query string or even work with existing query strings. So we're gonna start to explore this object with a existing query string. Okay, so inside the source code for this document, it looks like this. So inside the script tag, let's begin with an existing query string and then use the URL search params object to manipulate and display the data. Okay, so let's define a new constant up here, and this will be the existing query string. So I'm going to call this one query string, okay, equal to a fake query string such as name equals Dom and age equals 45 and occupation equals software developer. Okay, so we have our existing sample query string. You might see this on Google searches or, you know, YouTube searches, and we have an existing query string. So we're actually going to pass this string into a URL search params object to be able to easily manipulate it. Okay, so let's make a new constant down here and call this one USP, short for URL search params, equal to a new instance of a URL search params. Okay, inside this constructor it takes a single argument, that being in this case we're going to pass in the query string. Okay, so now we have two constants, the first one being the raw string, we're passing it into an instance of the constructor of the URL search params to give us an instance. Okay, so this lets us easily manipulate the string. So here we have, obviously we have name equals Dom, and so we have these little tokens which separate the data. This thing is gonna actually read this for us and provide useful methods to add or remove or display these key value pairs. So down here, I'm going to console.log the new USP object. Okay, so I'm going to save this and refresh the browser, and you can see we get a URL search params instance. If I expand this in the prototype, we see all these useful methods. Okay, so the main ones is going to be gets, sets, and toString. Okay, so let's explore these ones in this video. Okay, so back inside the code, let's begin with the toString method. So I'm going to say this, console.log usp.toString. Okay, and that one right there is going to convert this object back into the raw query string form. So if I save this and refresh the browser, we get the original raw query string. So you're going to want to use this toString method when you're making your HTTP requests, okay? And this actually will also encode your data. So if I was to add a curly brace at the end of this and then save this and refresh the browser, we actually get the encoded version of that curly brace. So that's obviously very useful also. Okay, so I'll just remove that. Okay, so let's use a for loop to loop over each one of these key value pairs. So down here, let's type out for, make a new constant, okay, and then use array destructuring, and we're gonna say key and then value of USP. So this means we're looping through each key value pair using array destructuring of the URL search params object. So now we have key, name, age and occupation, value, Dom 45 and software developer. So I can now console.log and then pass in here using a template string. I'm going to pass in here key is equal to and then value. Alright, so I can save this and refresh the browser, and we can see we have the individual data displayed right there. Alright, so obviously it's done all the hard work of actually extracting this for you, and it's presented it in a nice for loop. Okay, so now we have the get and set methods. So these are the two main methods. They let you get and set values. Okay, so up here before this loop, let's just get a key value pair. Okay, or should I say get a value? Okay, so let's make a new constant. I'm gonna call this one my name. Okay, equal to usp.get, and then pass in a key here. We're gonna pass in the name key. All right, so now we're getting the value of the name key. In this case, it's gonna be Dom right there. So name equals Dom, get name. Okay, so I can then console.log down here. I'm gonna say value for name is, and then pass in here my name. All right, so I can save this and refresh the browser, and we get value for name is Dom. Perfect, okay? We also have the set method. So the set method allows you to update an existing value by key, or actually create a new key value pair. Okay, so down here, let's use the set method. We're gonna say usp.set. We're gonna pass in a key followed by a value. So we're gonna say key, let's say name, and then change the name to Jeff, all right? So if I save this and refresh, we now have value for name is Dom as the existing name, or the previous name. It is now Jeff, and we have Jeff in the actual query string output, okay? We can also create a new key value pair. I can say usp.set the key of YouTube to the value of decode, okay? If I save this and refresh the browser, this time we see YouTube and decode right there, and it of course gets added to the actual outputted query string also, all right? Cool, so we have those three methods right there, get, set, and toString. So that is the main use of a URL search params object. However, this constructor takes in multiple different types. What you can do is actually begin with an object. Okay, so this is actually where it comes in handy quite a bit. So if I was to remove that line right there, just comment it out, and inside here, instead, I'm gonna pass an object. Okay, so right there, I'm gonna say name is Dom, age is 45, and occupation is software developer. So as you can see, I'm actually putting a space here instead of a plus sign, but basically we're passing in an object instead of a string. So if I save this and refresh, we get the same result. Okay, so here clearly, if you have an app where you're making a external request and you want to construct the actual form data or the get request parameters, you can definitely use this object syntax, because most of the time you actually want to construct this. So you start with an object, right, and you construct the actual query string. So that is probably the most common use case. Okay, so that is for using an existing query string or existing data. But what you can do is you can even begin with an empty object. So if I pass in nothing to the constructor, this time we have an empty URL search params instance. Okay, so if I was to save this and refresh, this time we get null for the name as it's an empty object, okay? And then we set the value of name, and then we're displaying the name and YouTube keys with their respective values, and then ending up with a query string. So that right there also may be a very common use case for this object. All right, so in a future video, I'll be talking about how to actually use this with the Fetch API to actually make requests, but for now, that is all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later.